In today's experiment, we're testing two different grow mediums, Coco Coir and peat moss. The microgreen we're using for this test is broccoli, and we'll only be using plain water for both groups, no nutrients added. For the tray setup, I'm using the large sprouting trays we sell on our website, with only one tray of medium in each group. The extra green trays will act as lids later on. In the first tray, we're using Coco Coir, which has been one of our favorite mediums for several years. It takes about 4.5 cups of medium to fill up these trays just below the brim. The medium sits in the mesh trays, which are just a bit shorter than the depth of the green trays that hold the water. Here's a close-up look at the Coco Coir. I make sure to evenly spread the medium, breaking up any clumps and lightly tamping it down with my palm, but not compacting it. For the second tray, we're using peat moss from SunGrow, which we found at our local tractor supply. I used the same 4.5 cups to fill the tray to the same height. Here's what the peat moss looks like up close. I level and tamp it just like the Coco Coir. Side by side, they look very similar, though the Coco Coir is slightly darker in color. Since we want to keep things consistent in this experiment, we're using exactly 20 grams of purple sprouting broccoli seed per tray, which is just over a tablespoon of seed. Starting with the Coco Coir tray, I evenly spread the seed across the tray, trying to avoid any clumping. I do the same for the peat moss tray, measuring out exactly 20 grams of the same seed and evenly spreading it. Now that both trays are seeded, it's time to give them their first watering. I mist both trays for about 20 seconds using a hand pump sprayer. The extra green trays will act as lids, trapping in moisture and allowing us to add 5 pounds of weight evenly to each tray. These trays will go onto our grow rack to germinate overnight. Today is day 3 of the grow. For the past 2 days, I've been misting the trays with water as needed. The Coco Coir tray is looking nice with even germination, and the medium has been holding water well. The peat moss tray looks similar at this stage, with no roots poking through the bottom yet. It's time to mist both trays again and put them back on the grow rack to finish germinating. I'll check them later today and mist again if needed. It's day 4 now. Both trays look denser today than yesterday due to a lot of overnight germination. At first glance, both the Coco Coir and peat moss trays look pretty much the same. But when I look a little closer, I notice that the peat moss tray has more tightly closed sprouting, while the Coco Coir tray is a bit more open, giving it a fluffier appearance. Since both trays are ready for the next step, I mist both with water and put them into blackout by flipping the top trays into a dome. I'll put them back on the grow rack and water again later today. It's day 6. Yesterday, I put both trays under the light for the first time and started bottom watering them with just plain water, no fertilizer added. You can already see the difference in the height of the trays. On the peat moss tray, there are little to no roots, but on the Coco Coir tray, there are plenty of roots, which I found to be interesting. What do you think could be the cause of this? Before watering, I checked both mediums for moisture, and both were retaining water well, so I skipped the first watering of the day and checked them later. On days 7 through 10, I checked in on the trays daily, bottom watering once or twice per day with plain water or as needed. If I skipped a watering for one group, I skipped it for both to keep things consistent. By day 11, both trays were ready for harvest and they looked noticeably different. The microgreens grown on the Coco Coir had even fluffy growth across the tray, with great color and larger leaves. They also had well-developed roots that looked healthy. The peat moss tray, however, showed quite a bit of uneven growth. The leaves were mostly small and underdeveloped, and there were little to no visible roots. I also noticed that both trays had different textures when I touched them, with the peat moss microgreens feeling almost rubber-like. It's harvest time, so let's take a closer look at both groups. I started with the peat moss tray. Harvesting from this tray was tough. Even with a sharp knife, I had to saw through the stems instead of cutting through them smoothly. The lack of rooting made the medium pull up as I harvested, making it tricky. The peat moss tray produced 82.4 grams of broccoli microgreens. Now let's harvest the Coco Coir group. From the first cut, it was clear the experience was totally different. The knife glided right through the stems with barely any pressure. Because of the healthy roots, I didn't have any troubles with the medium lifting up during harvest. The Coco Coir tray produced 159 grams of broccoli microgreens. Side by side, the peat moss group was shorter and darker in color, while the Coco Coir group looked more developed with beautiful color. The taste of the peat moss grown microgreens was okay, but I did not enjoy the woody texture and bitter aftertaste. The Coco Coir microgreens had the perfect brassica flavor and great texture I was looking for. So overall, the Coco Coir won this experiment. As for the peat moss, it didn't perform as well, likely due to its acidity. We don't believe it had anything to do with the brand of peat moss, just that peat moss is high in acidity naturally and can hinder growth. It would be interesting to try this experiment again, maybe by adjusting the pH of the Coco Coir or peat moss to see if we can either improve the result or get similar growth out of the peat moss. What do you think could help give peat moss a better chance as a standalone medium? Here's the complete breakdown of the results from this experiment. Let us know in the comments if you found a great way to grow with just peat moss. Happy growing, and thanks for joining us on this mini microgreen experiment.